Gym isn't the only place to get in a good workout. And today, personal trainer and life coach Ali McWilliams is going to take us through a full body workout here at Norman Clayton Park on Madison's West Side.
Love it. You ready to get hit in the full body? All right.
Let's do
First one we're going to do is upper body. So chest, arms, core, abs in tight. Chest comes down, press straight up, make sure your head is in line with that spine. If you want, you can go wider to make it a little bit easier. You choose, depending on where you're at.
So that spreads out your body weight a little better?
Good, yep. It helps with that balance. Tuck your tailbone, abs are in tight. Good core workout, good upper body workout. How are you feeling, little mama?
That's good. I like it.
All right, we're going to then, the second exercise, is going to flip around and do a single leg dip. So great for the arms and shoulders. And then by putting that leg up.
Would you like me just watching you?
Okay. You can use your leg muscles and use your core muscles there. You
quads
feel that?
Quads are working and triceps.
There you go, two for one.
So how many on each side would
you're
you
welcome.
Do?
You're welcome. Do 10 to 15 depending on where you're at.
Then switch.
Yep, perfect. Okay. All right, next one, a little balance challenge, little legs. So the split squat, so abs are in tight, find your balance.
Okay.
A little bit harder when you're pregnant, so Lee's doing an awesome job. Straight down, straight up, again, abs in, shoulders back. Breathe. You can do 10, you can do 15, you can set a timer, do 30 seconds, you choose.
Whew.
How are we doing?
It's amazing how your back leg, you feel that when you do that.
And the stability of your knees and your ankles. So the next one, step up. So you're going to stand nice and tall and come down. So
this is a high bench.
This is a high bench. So it's a lot for hips, but you can come all the way down. If it's high like this,
you
can stay here. If you have good balance, you can stand nice and tall.
Is it okay to use momentum to try to get up?
You can use your arms.
Okay.
Sure. Especially if you're having a struggle.
Yeah. This is a high bench.
Feel the hips in your butt yet?
Yes.
And the heart rate comes up.
Yeah, even
awesome.
My hip flexor right here.
Mm-hmm. It's good.
Okay, and our last one, we're
going to head on over.
Okay, so the fifth move.
Yeah, we're going to do an inverted row. So this is great. Lee's going to show you that even pregnant people can do this. You're going to walk straight out.
Under.
Yep, legs straight out, toes up.
Toes up.
There you go.
Okay.
And row. Pull your body up. Oh,
that's
girl.
Hard.
This is hard. And so if this is too hard, Lee can bend her knees.
Like
and
this.
Put her feet on the ground, squeeze her butt cheeks, tuck her tailbone, use her abs, and pull.
The abs that I no longer have.
You do too, still have it. What's great about the inverted row is pull-ups are hard for us girls, and this is a great way to strengthen the back and work your way up to those pull-ups.
Who said pregnant women can't do
that? That's right.
Yeah.
You rock. Nice job.
That was awesome. And a great example of another way to get a full body workout if you feel like you don't have time.
That's right.
Your kids can play.
Right.
While you're doing this.
Right, and you're a great role model for your children.
How many times a week do we need to get in full body? Once a week, or is it more?
Minimum of strength training twice a week.
Twice a week.
We need to build muscle mass.
Okay.
The more muscle you have, the more calories you burn.
Awesome, Ali. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
If you would like to read her blog on today's park workout, total body, or the other three that we've done.
That's right.
Just go to NBC15.com and click on this story.